As a counter to all these accounts, we have some missionary accounts. The missionary accounts are unanimous in condemning the custom of sati, and they declare the widow's funeral pyre. They compare it to the hellfire. In Christianity, fire is symbolic of hellfire. And in the Indian tradition, fire has a positive and purifying symbolism. So there are two different views of fire, and we find missionary accounts without exception in this period depicting the woman or the widow's pyre as resembling the fires of hell. Now it is very interesting that these references to hellfire, they make no mention of witch burning in Europe. And that means that they want to present India as something other. The last witch was burnt in Europe as late as 1780. And burning of heretics continued well after that. So, this attempt to equate sati fire with hellfire and to not refer to instances of widow woman burning in Europe and heretic burning in Europe is indicative of one way that certain missionaries wanted to project this custom in India. Now, the foreign accounts also have another interesting angle to them. And they say they link sati to the custom of marriage. And they say that the custom of marriage was central to Indian tradition. And Tavernier says that adultery is very rare among them. They are rarely men who are unfaithful to their wives or wives who are unfaithful to their husbands. And Manucci, who lived in India for almost 60 years, he says, for them, nothing is as important as marriage. He said the whole life is centered around the institution of marriage, which is the most important institution for them. And there is an Englishman, John Ovington. He wrote in 1689 that right from the time they are born, they are trained, to love. And he says that the Indian wives are so committed to love that they happily ascend the pyre when their husband dies. So these accounts, which I have mentioned, they emphasize the importance of marriage and conjugal loyalty in the Indian tradition. And there are other accounts which I can mention. One is a French editor, Bernard Picard. He came to India and he wrote in 1733. He said, the horror of the raging flames seems contemptible in their eyes. John Gross, he was an employee of the East India Company, and he wrote a book, A Voyage to the East Indies, in 1757. And he says that the Hindu woman's great affection and veneration for their husbands is because of this custom of early marriage among them. So there are various accounts which are trying to explain the complete loyalty, devotion, adoration of a woman to her husband. Some say it is because of early marriage that this habit is inculcated. Some say it's because of the centrality of the institution of marriage in the Hindu scheme of things. But these are the accounts that they offer us. I'll just give you one or two more accounts before I move on to the next section. There is Holwell. Holwell was for some time even acting governor of Bengal. And he wrote of an incident that happened before him in the year 1760. It happened in the company's factory at Kasim Bazar in the year 1742-1743. And the governor of that area was Sir Francis Russell. Now, what happened was that a Maratha died at the age of 28. His name was Ramchandra Pandit. And his widow was only 17 or 18 years old. And she said that I am now going to immolate myself. Now, this family was a family which had great standing among the merchants of Kasim Bazar. So the merchants, her relatives, they said, please don't do it. She refused to listen to them. Then they appealed to Lady Russell that please tell her not to do this. And Lady Russell also told the young girl of 17, 18, please do not immolate yourself. But this girl was adamant and she told Lady Russell that if I am not permitted to immolate myself, I will starve myself to death. So I will die in any case. So this is another case where we have an eyewitness account of a very senior official who becomes the governor of Bengal, who says that this young girl said, if you do not give me permission to immolate, I will starve myself to death, but I will leave the world along with my husband. There was a very noted Orientalist, Nathaniel Halhed. In 1779, he wrote a letter to Reverend George Costard in England. And he said, from all accounts, this seems to be a voluntary incident. I have not come across forced immolations. From the little that I know, it seems that it is always voluntary.